Hello everyone, I am Indrani Gunawardena from Department of Education, Central Province. We are going to discuss about the graphs and charts. Data presentation, analysis, interpretation are essential parts of all educational, commercial, health programs and as well as in our day-to-day activities. Children, what do you mean by data presentation? It is the visual representation of collected data in a summarized manner which is easy to understand quickly. I think you all know that there are many ways of representing data. Some of the popular ways include bar charts, pie charts, line graphs, scatter plots, tables. Out of them, the most widely used is the bar graph or the bar chart. Let's see what is the bar graph. It is a chart displayed in two axes that presents categorized data in a rectangular bars in proportion to the frequency or the number. You can see in the right hand side. First, let's talk about two axes. This is the vertical line and it is y-axis. Vertical line represents frequency or the number. This is horizontal axis. It is x-axis. Horizontal axis represents the categorized variables. Children, did you understand the bar graph? Then, before going to the lesson, let's see the adjectives which we need for comparison. There are two forms, comparative and superlative. When the adjective is many, comparative is more, and the superlative form is the most. You can see the picture in the right hand side. Many people, more people, the most people. If the adjective is less, the comparative is lesser and the superlative is least. Let's see how to apply these adjectives in a sentence. Example 1. There are many COVID-19 patients recorded in China. It is more than in Sri Lanka. But the most COVID-19 patients are recorded in America. Example 2. There are less number of vehicles in Kandy. The vehicles in Kandy are lesser than in Colombo. The least number of vehicles are found in Monaragala. Children, I think you can understand it. Now children, let's go to our question. First, you have to read the question with me. Read louder. The following bar chart shows the favorite food items for breakfast in grade 11 class of a school. Study the chart and write a description of it. Use about 100 words. Use the words given below. You will have to use these adjectives. Now look at this bar graph. In this bar graph, this is vertical line. It is y-axis. Vertical line represents number of children. This is horizontal line. It is x-axis. Horizontal line represents their favorite food items for breakfast. They are rice, roti, noodles, hoppers, bread, and string hoppers. You can see in the bar graph, the most preferred food item is bread. Their number is 16 and it is the highest. The second preferred food item is noodles. It is 12. Many students like to eat noodles. Some of the students like to eat hoppers. Their number is 8. Rice is eaten by 5 students. Only a few students like to eat rice. It is obvious. The least preferred food items are roti and string hoppers. Their numbers are same. It is 4. Equal number of students like to eat roti and string hoppers. It is the lowest. The number of students who like to eat rice is higher or more than the number of students who like to eat roti and string hoppers. According to the bar graph, I think the most preferred food item is bread and the least preferred food item are roti and string hoppers. Children, here I want to mention the same idea we can present in different sentence structures. Now, shall we see the activity 1? You have to read the question and write the answer. What does the bar graph show? Look at the bar graph and answer the question.
Favorite food items for breakfast in the grade 11 class of a school. Next question. What does the vertical line represent? Number of students. Next one. What does the horizontal axis represent? Favorite food items for breakfast. Next question. According to the bar graph, what is the most favorite food item for breakfast? Bread. How many students like it? 16.
A majority of students like to eat bread.
What is the second preferred food items of the students? Noodles. Next question. Is eaten by many students. Noodles is eaten by many students. Next question. How many students like to eat rice? 5. Next one. Only a few students like to eat rice. Next one. What are the least preferred food items they like to eat for breakfast? Roti and string hoppers. Next question. The preference for eating blank is the highest, and it is the blank favorite food item. The preference for eating bread is the highest, and it is the most favorite food item. Next question. The preference for eating blank and blank and the least preferred foods, and it is the blank number. What are the answers? The preference for eating roti and string hoppers are the least preferred foods, and it is the lowest number. Next question. Are there any equal number of preferences? Yes. What are they? Roti and string hoppers. Next question. Some of the students like to eat blank, and it is 8. What is the answer? Hoppers, and it is 8. Next one. Preference for eating blank is twice as the value of hoppers preference. What is the answer? Preference for eating bread is twice as the value of hoppers preference. Now last question. The number of students who like to eat rice is blank than roti and string hoppers. What is the answer? The number of students who like to eat rice is higher than roti and string hoppers.
Now this is the most important part. Method of writing the description of the above bar graph. First, introduction. Then, main features and comparisons. Finally, conclusion. When you write the introduction, explain the chart or graph using the information given in the topic or the question. You have to mention the two axes. And then, when you write the main features of the graph and comparison, you have to discuss the prominent features of the graph, that is, similarities and dissimilarities. And you have to make the comparisons where necessary using these adjectives. Many, less, more, some, few, majority, etc. You have to make the comparisons many, more, less, least, a few, some, majority, etc. If you want to combine two sentences, you can use the following words: whereas, but, while, although. If you want to show comparison and contrast between two sentences, you can use however, by contrast, on the other hand, in comparison. And you can start the sentence using the following phrases: we can see that, it could be noticed that, it is obvious that. Finally, a conclusion. State most prominent features in the bar graph. You have to forward your own idea using these phrases according to the bar graph overall. Now children, you can understand how to write a description. Now your second activity, fill in the blanks using these words. Least, most, many, some, a few, highest, most, equal. The above bar graph represents the favorite food items of grade 11 students of a school which they preferred for their breakfast. The vertical axis represents number of students, while the horizontal axis shows the favorite food items. They are roti, noodles, hoppers, bread, and string hoppers. The blank number of students like to eat bread, and it is 60, the most number of students. It is the highest. Blank, students like to eat noodles. It is 12, many students. Only blank, students like to eat rice. A few students like to eat rice, which is 5. Blank, of the students prefer hoppers, and their number is 8. Some of the students prefer hoppers, and their number is 8. The bar graph reveals that an blank number of students prefer to eat roti and string hoppers, equal number of students. According to the bar graph, it is obvious that blank food item is bread. Most favorite food item is bread. However, the least preferred food items are roti and string hoppers for their breakfast. Children, now you can write the description of the above bar graph. This is the answer. Now finally, I want to mention, in your O-level English paper, there are 2 papers.
And you will be given 3 hours.
Paper 1, 1 hour, question number 1 to 8. Second paper, 2 hours, question number 9 to 16. A similar question that we discussed will come under question number 14 in your second paper. This is your marking criteria. You will be given marks. If you write all the points, you can get 3 marks for the content. You will be given marks for content. If you write all the points, you can score 3 marks. If you write grammatically correct sentences for the language, you can score another 3 marks. If you write correct format and organization as we discussed earlier, we can score another 2 marks. If you use correct mechanics of writing, you can get another 2 marks. I think you can get 10 marks easily for this question. Moreover, you will get tables, pie chart, line graphs other than bar graphs. Use the same format. Introduction, main features of the graph and comparison, and conclusion. Now there is another question. The following pie chart shows a survey conducted at Rural Mahavidyalaya on what children like to play in their free time. Study it and write a description about it. Use 100 words. Use the following words in your description. Highest percentage, lowest percentage, more than, less than, equal. Fill in the blanks using these words. Equal, majority, the least, less than, more than, lowest percentage, LA, chess, 35, lowest. 5, 15, highest percentage. Now, the above chart shows a survey conducted at Rural Mahavidyalaya on what children like to play in their free time. The sports they like to play are chess, cricket, hockey, football, volleyball, and alley. The blank of students like to play cricket, which blank? The majority of students like to play cricket, which is 35%. Blank is played by 20%, and it is the second highest favorite sport. LA is played by 20% and it is the highest favorite sport. Blank. Number of students like to play hockey. The least number of students like to play hockey, which is blank percent, 5%. It is the blank preferred sport, lowest preferred sport, and blank number of students like volleyball and football, which is blank percent, and equal number of students like to play volleyball and football, which is 15%, which are less than cricket and LA. 1/10 of the students like to play blank during their free time, and it is blank hockey. 1/10 of the students like to play chess during their free time, and it is more than hockey. Accordingly, blank is for cricket, while blank is for chess. Accordingly, the highest percentage is for cricket, while the lowest percentage is for chess. I think you enjoy this lesson. Good luck.